I'm Race Rage, aka Minnie Miller. Let's go. I'm a black political rapper.
And knocked down, but I claw my way back. Reclaim my throne, honey, pick up my job slack. It's time, although I don't know yet how I might turn like an Antifa soldier. I just told ya, babe, what's your space? Determined to be an
Yeah, when I was writing Diamonds and Sapphires, I kind of was at one of the darkest points of my life. I have a bunch of like joint conditions and chronic pain, and I'd fallen off a ladder. And so I was really immobile at the time. I couldn't walk. I was having pretty bad nerve pain. I was using a wheelchair and I couldn't sit up for very long. And so I ended up losing my job because of that, and then losing my house because I lost my job. And everything just kind of spiraled. And then I was in sort of a really dark point with my mental health as well, and was sort of in a really bad place with panic attacks and anxiety, and just sort of thinking like I need to do something with this.
Deep pressure funds beauty from it like sapphires. Diamonds and sapphires. So tell me what you know about climbing out the sinkhole.
So I wrote that song to try and, I guess, talk about, like, what's next? Like, how do you get out of this hole, and how do you get back to where you were and reclaim that energy? And, like, you need to do something with those emotions, and you need to do something with that negativity. And for me, yeah, turning that into creativity is a positive way to, I guess, alchemize that pain or alchemize those experiences and turn them into something positive that maybe can relate to somebody else who's gone through something similar.
I just told you that shit was brutal. Alchemize pain to create something fruitful. Oppressors gonna tell your resistance is futile. It's all we got, cause our healing is crucial. Our refusal to live without scruples.
I guess the name Race Rage, I chose that name because it sort of marked a time in my life where I was learning a lot. I was new to a lot of politics and a lot of critical thinking, and I guess I was starting to think about myself and my place in the world as a racialized person. I grew up with the white side of my family, so I grew up really not thinking of myself as a black person, as a person of color at all. I experienced a lot of racism, but I was pretty oblivious to why.
One, two, one, two.
And yeah, that period of time, I was kind of just beginning to identify as a person of color and a black person. And I was starting to learn a lot more about race politics and the fact that, you know, we're living in a white supremacy, and that did start to make me angry. And that name was a way of really kind of claiming that knowledge and claiming that identity and claiming that anger and allowing myself to be comfortable with feeling rage that came from a righteous place and expressing it, which is something that I feel like myself and a lot of other people who are socialized as girls are really not socialized to do. It's not an acceptable emotion. I really wanted to collaborate primarily with other people of color and just, I guess, kind of do something positive with that rage.
I'm tired, but fueled with my old fire, my desire to push through the muck and mire. Reach summits I deserve to soar higher. My heart promised, but once more I aspire.
No spaces like hip-hop, it's mostly men. The fact that I'm there and that I'm able to say what I'm saying is subversive and is radical. Speaking from my own experience, I don't attempt to speak for anybody else, but the fact that I do exist on the margins that I exist on, I'm non-binary, I'm black, I'm queer, I'm disabled, I have mental illness, like, you know, come from lower socioeconomic class status, like, all those things means that, like, when I make my voice heard, at, like, being able to perform on stage in front of a whole bunch of people, or, you know, be played on radio and reach a whole bunch of people that I wouldn't otherwise be able to speak to, that is important politically.
Our refusal to live without scruples. No shame, no stigma, revolution is truthful.